Okay, this is the picture of the more complex model. Now you have three different controls. You can select the base wage, you can select the overtime wage, and you can select the unearned income. At this point, the overtime wage is set exactly equal to the base wage. Let me show what happens when I raise the unearned income. That shifts the budget line up parallel to what it was before. An increase in the unearned income is just like an increase in the time endowment. It creates a parallel movement in the budget line upwards. Okay, so I'm going to lower that a little bit. Now let me mention that you don't get to choose this here, but the cutoff for overtime is 8 hours of work. So only hours of work over eight earn overtime. And now what's going to happen is I'm going to start increasing the overtime wage. And if you increase it just a little bit, nothing happens in behavior. There's actually a kink in the budget line happening at 16 hours of leisure or 8 hours of work. And let's keep on increasing it. And then as we raise it enough, now all of a sudden the guy chooses to do overtime and now is having the choice follow this price consumption path, not the original price consumption path, but the one for the overtime wage, which is as if the price of consumption has fallen, but the time endowment is less because of this kink here in the old budget line. So the effect of overtime is actually, when it's operational, is to dramatically reduce leisure consumption or dramatically raise labor supply, and it looks like that in this picture. Let's take a look now in the labor supply picture. This is the same story, but in a different representation. I'm now going to lower the overtime wage, and this purple labor supply curve is the overtime labor supply curve. And watch, when I lower it a little bit more, it jumps to what the labor supply would be without overtime. So the consumer at a low overtime rate doesn't choose overtime at all. At the high overtime rate, then moves up this labor supply curve. This is because without the overtime, his labor supply is much less than 8 hours. If he were going to work above 8 hours, even with the overtime, even without the overtime wage, then there would be a continuous response to an increase in the overtime wage.